So now things will become even more complicated. I'm going to give you a list of numbers, slightly different from the one before. Those are actually floating numbers. They have a decimal point. And I want you to implement a function variance that takes in data and returns a single number, which is the variance of the data. So for the data set I'll be giving you, it so turns out the variance is 62.572. Now, some hints. First, you're going to use the function mean that you already programmed. So it's in your code. Just use it. And then the trick that I want to play is we have our list here inside the function data. And I want to transform this into a new list called ndata. It is the normalized data, which effectively is the data minus the mean, which I call mu. So you compute the mean, call it mu, perhaps, and then subtract from the data, from each data item, the mu. And the subtraction is not entirely trivial to make the new data set. And the commands I've been using is I iteratively construct with a for loop the new data set. First, I set it to an empty list, and then there's this function called append, dot append. And whatever's inside the function, you got to figure this out, will be appended to this list over here. So with an initial assignment of an empty list and a for loop where I go through all the data items and I append the appropriate thing to this new data, I get out this new data list. And then I can apply the same mean function to the new data list, and that gives me the variance. You got it? If not, listen to the video again. So here's the coding environment, a data set. I've given you the function mean that we've programmed before, and now you are to program the function variance. So that when you print variance of the data set, you get the desired 62.572884.